200 a crate. That's the going rate, right?
Maybe.
We'll need a dozen to start.
In season two, Ah Sahm and Young-jun are looking to expand the opium business by getting a domestic supplier, which Father Jun would never do. Vega introduces them to Happy Jack, who's one of the prime opium dealers of the time.
Because Happy Jack is such a big presence in the Barbary Coast, a very menacing presence too, and he runs the majority of the opium dealings in the Barbary Coast, Vega knows that Ah Sahm's in good hands with Happy Jack. He will still have a shroud of secrecy around his opium dealing.
Ah Sahm is very confident about this deal, and although Young-jun agrees with him, Young-jun has more reservations. However, if Ah Sahm, who's been a brother-in-arms through a lot of battles, thinks it's the right move, let's do this.
If Ah Sahm and Young-jun just let Father Jun do his thing, they think that maybe the Hop Wei would just gradually be taken over. They think they're doing what's best for the Tong.
Jacob told me you were back with the Hop Wei.
Did you ask me here just to disapprove of me? Because honestly, I'm a little busy.
Penny and Ah Sahm, I mean, they've been through a lot. In season one, they've dared to hope there may be a world in which they could be together. They've each been through so much in the interim, and they're fighting their own battles right now.
At the end of season one, Penny and Ah Sahm have gone their separate ways. When we meet them back in season two, Penny probably thinks that she would have nothing to do with him until she's in a situation where she needs him.
Leary's goons are still harassing my men.
Ah Sahm, he's finished with Penny. He got caught up with that. And that's not what he's supposed to be doing right now.
I need protection.
Which, if you think about it, makes you a criminal.
You see her morals being questioned and her whole kind of sense of right and wrong. And he represents that for her. He's like, now you want my help? She kind of has to just get on the knees and just say, yeah, I need help.
San Francisco police, this is a raid. John's out.
The scenes that really surprised me this season in terms of my reaction to them were the scenes in the crib brothels that Nelly goes and busts and saves these, you know, these young Chinese girls from. Being there on set, I was surprised at how affected I was by seeing these young actresses play out these dark, hopeless scenes that these young Chinese girls really did have to go through.
Nellie Davenport, who's based on the real-life Donaldina Cameron, is a woman of wealth from white mainstream society who makes it her mission to rescue sex slaves from crib brothels.
Miss Davenport, you not come back here for many months.
In coming across Ah Toy, Nellie challenges Ah Toy, calls out any element of hypocrisy she sees about Ah Toy. And in doing so, I think it forces Ah Toy to look at the choices she's made and maybe the justifications she's made for the world that she's built around herself.
My girls can go anytime they want. I own no one.
The Soy Sing have apparently decided to start selling opium now. But we have an opportunity here to send a message.
A message?
That the Lamazee will protect what's ours. Every bit as much as the Hop Wei.
The first few episodes of season two, you meet Mai Ling in a place where her guard is up and there is a mask that she has to wear to protect herself. You see her break for the first time and she is vulnerable with Liang.
We can tell that Liang is trying to bring Mai Ling back on a path that he believes is the right way for her, right way for Tong. Of course, Mai Ling has her own perspective of where the Tong's gonna go. And then, you know, to reach the point that to do something to save her, to save Langzi, like, kaboom.
Hey, it's Lisa here with your daily action movie trivia. Did you know that for Bruce Lee's Way of the Dragon, the actor handpicked Chuck Norris as his opponent for the movie's climactic fight? Norris was one of the few martial artists fast enough to convincingly beat Lee. The fight scene filled up a quarter of the script and took more than 45 hours to film. Stay up to date on all things actions by subscribing and don't forget to click the notification bell.